Hello everyone, here is Radovan from BSS. RHCE EX300 exam. Configure a database on Red Hat Enterprise Linux. RHCE exam task Configure a database is predecessor to RHCE exam task Query a database. So if you will fail to successfully configure a database, you will fail also task to query a database, which means you will lose points for two tasks. Our given task is configure a database, create a MariaDB database named employees on System1 such that the following conditions exist. The database should contain the contents of the database dump from http://rhgh.domain9.example.com/materials/employees.mdb. The database should be accessible from localhost only. Other than the root user, this database only allows queries from the user Luigi. This user should have the password wakennym. The root user should have the password wakennym and must not be allowed to log in without using a password. First, we will install MariaDB and mariadb-client group of packages. Yum, groupinstall, MariaDB, mariadb-client. Enable MariaDB to start automatically after reboot. systemctl. Enable. MariaDB. Verify if MariaDB is configured to start automatically after reboot. systemctl. is-enabled MariaDB. Start MariaDB. systemctl. Start MariaDB. Check status of MariaDB. systemctl status MariaDB. Verify that MariaDB is listening on all interfaces. ss-tulpn. Pipe grab mysql. Part of this RHCE task is that the database should be accessible from localhost only. So we enable the skip networking directive. vi/etc/my.cnf. Add line skip-networking is equal 1 to mysql d section. skip-networking is equal 1. Restart MariaDB. systemctl. Restart MariaDB. Verify status of the MariaDB. systemctl status MariaDB. Verify that MariaDB is not listening on any interface. ss-tulpn pipe grab mysql. This command shouldn't return anything. Secure MariaDB service using the mysql_secure_installation tool. Set the root password to wakennym and answer yes to all other questions. mysql_secure_installation. Enter current password for root. Enter for known. We haven't set root password yet, so we press enter here. Set root password. It is part of this RHCE task that root user should have the password wakennym and must not be allowed to log in without using a password. So press lower or uppercase Y for yes. Type new password which should be wakennym here. Re-enter new password. remove anonymous users. Our RHCE task says that addendroot user this database only allows queries from the user Luigi. So we press Y for yes now. Disallow root login remotely. Normally, root should only be allowed to connect from localhost. This ensures that someone cannot guess at the root password from the network. So we press Y for yes here as well, as this one is important security hardening. And also our RHCE task says that the database should be accessible from localhost only anyway. We will answer yes also to our last two questions. Remove test database and access to it. Reload privilege tables now. Connect to MariaDB database as user root using MySQL client. MySQL minus U root minus P. MySQL is a client to connect to the MariaDB database server. Minus U is option to specify the username for this connection. Root username for this connection. Minus P is option to prompt for password. Our RHCE task is to create MariaDB database named employees on system 1, so we will create it using command create database employees semicolon. We will verify if database employees has been created successfully with command show databases semicolon. Our next task is to create user Luigi and set password wakennym for him. Create user Luigi at localhost. Identified by single quote wakennym single quote semicolon. Database should allow queries from the user Luigi. Grant select on employees.star to Luigi at localhost semicolon. Now we need to reload privileges using flush privileges command. Flush privileges semicolon. Display privileges that are assigned to user Luigi. Show grants for Luigi at localhost semicolon. Disconnect from MariaDB database and exit MySQL client. Exit semicolon. Connect to MariaDB database as user Luigi. MySQL minus U Luigi minus P. Connect to database employees to confirm that user Luigi can use it. Use employees. Semicolon. Disconnect from MariaDB database and exit MySQL client. Exit. Semicolon. The database should contain the contents of database dump from http://rhgh.domain9.example.com/materials/employees.mdb. First, install wget-utility to download employees.mdb file. Yum, install wget. Download employees.mdb file. Wget http://rhgh.domain9.example.com/materials/employees.mdb. Reload employees.mdb dump file which was written by MySQL dump. MySQL minus U root minus P employees lower than employees.mdb. Verify if employee's database was restored successfully and if user Luigi can see and query all tables. Connect as user Luigi. MySQL minus u Luigi minus p. Use employee's database. Use employees. Semicolon. List tables. Show tables, semicolon. Query data from employees table. Select star from employees, semicolon. Disconnect from MariaDB database. Exit semicolon. Please note that if you forget to set password for database account Luigi, or if you set wrong password for database user, you can set password also later. Connect to MariaDB database as user root. MySQL minus u root minus p. Set new password for user Luigi. Set password for Luigi at localhost is equal password. Left parenthesis, single quote, wakennym, single quote, right parenthesis, semicolon. Please remember that on your RHCE exam, Selinux must be set to enforcing mode and firewall must be running. In this task, database should be accessible from localhost only, so we don't have to create any firewall rule. Also, I haven't experienced any Selinux-related issues in this task during RHCE exam, preparation to exam, or when I was creating this video tutorial. Please also remember that all your RHCE tasks will be graded after reboot, so it is recommended for you to reboot System 1 server and double-check your MariaDB database after reboot. Here is summary of commands which we used today. Related RHCE task is to query a database. Please watch my next video tutorial Query a Database. Link to this video tutorial can be found in description as well as links to another interesting video tutorials. Thanks for watching, guys. Please leave questions and comments below, like my video and subscribe. Thanks for watching.